हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू डाटा साइंस लवर्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल टॉक अबाउट डाटा स्ट्रक्चर्स इन पाइथन। वी विल लर्न अबाउट लिस्ट, टपल, सेट एंड डिक्शनरी विद देयर प्रॉपर्टीज एंड विद द लाइव एग्जांपल्स। व्हाट इज अ लिस्ट इन पाइथन? अ लिस्ट इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ डिफरेंट डाटा टाइप्स लाइक इंटीजर्स, फ्लोट्स, स्ट्रिंग्स एज वेल एज ऑब्जेक्ट्स। ईच एलिमेंट और वैल्यू ऑफ द लिस्ट इज कॉल्ड एन आइटम। We can also say that a list is a sequence of items. A list is created within these types of square brackets. This is the format of a list, which shows that a list is created within square brackets and it can contain the integer, float or string values or a combination of all these three data types. So to create a list, we have to write our list name and in the square bracket, we have to write our items. In this list, you can see that these are the integers values, these are the float values, and these are the string values. So a list has been created. To show this list, we will simply use the print function. So this is the list. We can also create a list with only integers values like this, with only float values like 1.2, 3.4, 5 point this, and also with the string values. Like this. So these are the types of a list which contains the integer, float or string values in it. What is an index in list? If I create a list like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then the index of a list starts from the 0. The 1 values present at 0 index, the second, the 2 values present at first index, the 3 values present at second index. Means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the indexes of the list. The index of the list doesn't start from 1, it starts from 0. You have to remember this thing. The properties of a list are as follows. The first property is a list allows duplicate items or values in it. What does it mean? If I create a list with items like 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, then a list A name has been created, and if I want to print this list, then you can see that this list contains the duplicate values. 2, 2 and 5, 5 are the duplicate values. We can also create a list with duplicate string or float values. Like this. All the elements of a list have to be separated with this comma. Now if I print this list, then you can see that this list contains the duplicate string values hi. The second property of the list is a list is mutable. It means a list items can be changed after creating the list. The first function is append function. The append function is used to enter a new value at the end of a list. If I create a list, this is a simple list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and if I want to enter a new value 6 at the end of this list, then I will simply use the append function, and in the bracket I will write the value that I have to enter at the end of list. Now if I print this list, then you can see that the 6 has been added at the last value, at the last position of this list. The second function is insert function. The insert function is used to insert a new value at a given index in the list. To use this function, we will simply create a list like this. If I print this list, then you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is the original list. If I want to enter 2.5 at the second index, then I will write the a dot insert function, and in the bracket I will write the index at which I have to enter the value. I have to enter the value at second index and the value which I have to enter. If I print this list, then you can see 2.5 has been added at the second index of this list. As I earlier told you that the index of the list starts from 0. So this was our 0 index, this was our first index, this was our second index. Now we have added a value 2.5 at our second index. So the value of the second index has been changed to 2.5. This is how we can use the insert function. The next one is index function. The index function show the index of a value. What does it mean? This is a list which we have created, and if I want to see what is the index of this 3, then I will simply use the index function for it. In the index function, I will write the value or element of which I have to check the index. If I run this command, then it will show that the index of 3 is 3. It means 0, 1, 2 and 3. Means the 3 value is present at the third index. If I check the index of 2.5, what does it shows that the 2.5 value is present at the second index. 0, 1 and 2. This is the second index where the 2.5 value is present. The next is remove function. The remove function is used to delete a value from the list. This is our list, and if I want to remove the value of 2.5, then I will simply use the remove function. In the bracket, I will write the value which I have to remove from the list and run this. Now if I see this list, then you can see that the 2.5 value has been removed from this list. It is showing only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is how we can remove a value from the list from any position. The next is pop. The pop function is used to delete a value from a particular index. If you see here, this is a list, and if I want to remove this 3 value which is present now at the second index, 0, 1 and 2, then I will use the pop function. In the pop function, I have to write the index value, not the item which we have to delete. Here I write the index. If I run this, and it shows that the 3 item has been removed from this list. And if I have a look at this list, then you can see that the 3 has been removed from the list. So this is the difference between the remove function and the pop function. The remove function is used to delete a value from the list, while the pop function is used to delete a value at a particular index from the list. In the remove function, we have to pass out the value which we have to delete, while in the pop function, we have to pass the index. Now, what is indexing in list? Suppose we have a list x equal to 1, 2, 3, 5. Or I can say 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. This is our list. Now, as I told you that this is our 0th index, this is 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th index. Now, if I want to check the index of an item in the list, I will simply use the index function. If I write 13, then it is showing that the 13 is present at the second index of the list X. The next is, we can also use the index value to show what is present at that particular index. If I write here 3, this is the index value, and run this command, then it is showing 14. It means that at the third index, 14 is present. 0, 1, 2 and 3. At third index, 14 is present. If I want to show the values in the range of some index, then I can use this Here I have write the starting index and the end index. It will show the value 1 lesser than the end index. Here you can see the result as 13 and 14. While this is our first index, this is our 0th index, this is our 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. The 4th index is actually 15, but it is showing the values as 14. Why? Because it always shows the one value lesser than the end index. You have to keep in mind this thing. Again, if I write the end in the starting index as 2 and the end index as 5, then it will show all the values that are present from second index to the fourth index, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4th. This is how we can use the indexing. What is a tuple in Python? A tuple is a collection of different data types like integers, floats or strings. It is just like a list. Each element or value of the tuple is called an item. We can also say that a tuple is a sequence of different items. A tuple is created within this type of round brackets. Now, how a tuple is different from a list? There are two main differences, which are: a list is created within the square brackets, while a tuple is created within round brackets. The second difference is the list item can be changed, while the tuple items cannot be changed once it is created. So how to create a tuple? This is the format of a tuple. It is showing that it can contain the integer, float or string values in the round brackets. So to create a tuple, we have to write our tuple name like a, and we can put the integer values. This is a tuple with all integer values. And if I show you, then this is a tuple with all float values. Similarly, we can create a tuple with all the string values also. So this is a tuple with all string values. We can also create a tuple with the combination of all three these data types. Like, first I write the integer items, then I write the float items, and I can also write the string items in it. So these are the format of a tuple. If I show you the type, then you can also check the type of this, like this type and the tuple name. If I want to see the type of B, then it is showing that this is a tuple. So this is how you can create a tuple. Next is, what is the index in tuple? So if I have this tuple and the index of the tuple starts from the 0, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The index of the tuple starts from 0, just like it starts in the list. The one value is present at the 0th index, the two value is present at the first index, while the three value is present at the second index. If I want to see what is present at my 4th index, then I can use this function or this command, where I have write the tuple name and the index position in the square brackets. It is showing that at 4th index 6.788 is present. Let's see, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So at 4th index 6.788 is present. If I want to see what is present at my 6th index, then it will show that Python is present at my 6th index. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So remember, the index of the tuple as well as a list starts from the 0. Now, what are the properties of a tuple? The first property is, a tuple allows duplicate items or values in it. If I create a tuple name x, and if I write some duplicate values, like this. Then it is acceptable in a tuple. As you can see here, 3 is 2 times present, 2.3 is also 2 times present, and high is also 2 times present in the tuple. It means a tuple can be created with the duplicate values in it. The second property of the tuple is a tuple is immutable. Immutable means it means a tuple item cannot be changed after creating the tuple. So if I look at this tuple which I have created above, and if I want to see what is present at my second index, then it is showing that at second index 2 the 3 value is present. Now if I want to change this 3 with 4, I can use this function, but it will show an error because tuple doesn't support the change of the items once a tuple is created. So this is the main difference between a tuple and a list. The items of a list can be changed, while the items of a tuple cannot be changed once it is created. Now, what is indexing in tuple? If this is a tuple, and if I want to see the index 0, then 1 is present at index 0, and if I want to see the 6, then the high is present at the 6 index. Now, if I want to see all the items present between 0 and 6 index, then I can write like this. It will show the items between 0 and the 5th index. At the end, I have write the 6 as the end index, but it will show one value lesser than the end index, means 5. As you can see, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5th. It is showing the value till 2.3, means till the 5th index. Similarly, if I write 0 to 7, then it will show value till the 6th index. As you can see, this is our 6th index high. And we can also write like this, then it will show all the items starting from 0th index till the last index. Here you can see all the items are present here. Now, why we use tuple? Tuple is used if you have to create a sequence of constant items which not needs to be changed later in the program. This is the main benefit of the tuple. What is a set in Python? Just like list and tuples, a set is also a collection of different data types like integers, floats, or strings. The each element or value of the set is called an item. We can also say that a set is a sequence of different items. A set is created within these type of curly braces. Now, how a set is different from a list or a tuple? A list is created within the square brackets, while a tuple is created within the round brackets. And a set is created within these type of curly braces. The second difference is the list items can be changed, while the tuple items cannot be changed, and in the set we can add or remove any element once this set is created. Now this is the format of a set. It is showing that there are two curly braces, and in the curly braces we can add the integer, float, or string values, or a combination of all these three data types. So to create a set, we have to write our set name like A and write the curly braces, and in the braces we have to enter the values like this. So this is a simple set that we have created. If I want to show you the type of this, then it will show this set as a type. We can also create a set with all the float values also like this. This is also a set which contains all the float values. We can also create a set with all the string values also. This is a set which contains all the string values. Now to create a set which contains all these three data types, we can simply write like this. These are the integers values. These are two float values, and we can also write the string values like this. So this is how we can create a simple set. Now if we talk about the index in a set, then we can say that a set is unindexed. What does it mean? If this is a set that we have, and if I want to see what is present at my first index, then it will not show, it will show an error. Similarly, if I want to see what is present at my fourth index, then it will show an error. It means there is no index present in a set, means index are not there in the concept of the sets. Now if we talk about the properties of a sets, then the first property is it arranges the items in the ascending order. What does it mean? If I create a set like 2, 1, 3, 6, 5, and if I print this set, then you can see that all the items that we have written in the sets are arranged in the ascending order, like 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Similarly, it will arrange all the float as well as the string items in the ascending order. If I write 3, 2, 5, 1 and some float values like this, and also some string values like this, and if I print this set, then you can see that all the items of the sets are arranged in the ascending orders, like 1, 1, 2, 3, 3.2, 5, and then the all string values are also arranged in their alphabetical order. So this is the first property of a set. The second property is a set doesn't allow duplicate items or value in it. If I create a set like 1, 2, 3, 3, and 5, 6, 7, 7, and if I print this, then you can see all the duplicate items like 3 and 7 are removed in the resulted set. Similarly, it will remove any string value also and only show the unique values of the set. This is the second property of a set. The third property of the set is we can add or delete items in a set. If we have a set like this, and I want to add a new element in this set, then I will write the set name and the dot, and I will press the tab button on the keyboard. It will show some option to me like add. I will select this add option, and in the bracket I will write the value or element that I have to add in this set. If I write 67 and see the resulted set, then 67 has been added. Similarly, if I want to add 1.5 here, then you can see that 1.5 has been added between 1 and 2, which shows the set's items are arranged in the ascending order by default. When we add 67, the 67 adds to the last position. While we add the 1.5, it adds to this position between 1 and 2. If I want to remove any element from the set, then I will write my set name and dot and press the tab button and use the remove function from it. If I want to remove this 7.8, then I will pass this value here and the value has been removed, as you can see here. If I want to remove 67, I can write the function name or I can select it from the tab button. You can see that the 67 has been removed. Now there is a different option like pop. What does it mean? If I use the pop function, then it will remove a value randomly from this set. If I use this, then it is showing that one has been removed from this set. If I again use the pop function, then it is showing that the 2 has been removed from this set. Here you see that 1 is removed, which was at our first position, but when we use pop second time, then the 2 was removed, which was our second position. It means that if we use pop function, then the values are removed randomly from this set. Again, if I use the pop function, then this time this removed the 4, and the resultant set will be our this. What is a dictionary in Python? A dictionary is a combination of keys and values. These keys or values may be integers, floats, or strings. The keys and values are separated by a colon like this. A dictionary is also created within these type of curly braces. This is the format of a dictionary. Here you can see there are three combination of keys and values. There is key 1, key 2, key 3, and there are corresponding values, value 1, value 2, and value 3. These three combination are put in the curly braces. Now, to create a dictionary, we have to write our dictionary name like D, and within the curly braces, we have to write our key value pairs. For example, if I write roll number and name of the students of a class, then I can write like this. One roll number, name is Ram. Second roll number, name is Shyam. And for third roll number, name is Shiva. So this is how we can create a dictionary. Here you can see that 1, 2 and 3 are the keys, while Ram, Shyam and Shiva are the values of the dictionary. We can also check the type like this. This is showing that this is a dictionary. Now we can create dictionary with putting all integer values as the key, or all float values as the key, or all string values as the key. First, if I create a dictionary which contains all the integer values as key, then I can write our dictionary name, and in the curly braces I have to write my keys and values. This is my first key, and for corresponding key there is a corresponding value like A. This is my second key, and this is my second value B, and this is my third key, this is my third value C. So here you can see that all keys are of integer type, while all the values are of string types. We can also create a dictionary like this. Here, if you see, all the keys are of integers type 1, 2, 3, and all the values are of float types 1.2, 2.3, 4.5. The third example is here, if you see, all the keys are of integer types, and all the values are also of integer types like 100, 240, and 999. So this is how we can create a dictionary with all the integer as their key position. Now, if you want to put the float values as the keys, then we can also create like this 1.2 as my key and corresponding value, and 2.4 as my key and any corresponding value, and 5.6 as my key and my corresponding value. So this is how we can create a dictionary with all float values as their key and the string values as their values. Consider one more example here. If I write 1.2 and 34, if I write 2.4 and 4, 5, 6, anything I can write here. In this example, we have written all the float keys and the values are of integer types, as you can see. If you notice one thing here, that when we write integer or float value, we are not writing any code like this, but when we are writing the string values, we are putting in the quotes. Means all the string values are always put in the quotes. Now if we consider third example, then we can use all the keys as floating data types and also all the values as the float, like this. Next, if we want to use the string data type as our keys, then we can say like this. In this example, as you can see, all the keys are of string types while all the values are of integer types. Similarly, if I write a and 2.3 and I write b and 3.455, and if I write c, in this example, if you notice, all the keys are of integer types while all the values are of float types. If we consider our third example, then I can write like this. In this example, all the keys and all the values are of string types. So these are the formats of the dictionaries, how you can create a dictionary with integer and float and string values as the keys and values combination. Now, if we come to the properties of the dictionary, the first property is it is a combination of keys and values, as we saw in the above example. If I print the above dictionary, then you can see there are three combinations, or you can say pairs of keys and values. This is the first pair, this is my second pair, and this is my third pair. So a dictionary is always a combination of key and value. A dictionary doesn't allow duplicate keys in it, but we can enter duplicate values while creating a dictionary. Let's see. If I write my dictionary name as A, and if I write A and give some values, if I write second key B and give some values, again if I write A and give some values, so this is the dictionary that we have created. If I print this dictionary, then what you see here, that all the duplicate keys are missing here. Means only one key is present, and the key that is chosen is the last key. As you can see here, A5. while A1 combination and A3 combination has been removed. Means additionally doesn't allow the duplicate keys. These are the keys A, B, A, C, A, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the values. Now this, it is also saying that we can enter the duplicate values. If we write another dictionary like A1 and 2 and C2 1, so this is the dictionary, and here you can see that the duplicate values are acceptable, means 1 and 1 we can enter the duplicate values in a dictionary, while we can enter the duplicate keys while creating a dictionary. The third property is a dictionary is mutable. It means we can add, remove or change the items of a dictionary. We will add, remove or change the items in our second playlist. Here I am showing some more functions of the dictionary. Suppose I have a dictionary Suppose this is my dictionary, I am copying it. So this is my dictionary. Now the first function is get function. The get function is used to get the values against a key. How to use it? I have to write the dictionary name and dot, and I have to press the tab on keyboard. It will show some options to me like this. If I choose the get option and if I enter a key in this like this, then you can see that it is showing the corresponding values against the Delhi key, which is 1. If I again use this, we can also type the option or we can choose from the tab button. If I like here second key, which is Noida, then you can see that it is showing the corresponding value against this key Noida. Delhi, Meerut, Noida are our keys, 1, 2, 3 are our values. The second option is, or second function is items. The items show all the items of the dictionary. If this is our dictionary and if I use the item function or item option here and run this, then you can see all the pairs of keys and values are shown here. Means it will show all the items that are present in the dictionary. The next is keys. The keys show all the keys of the dictionary. If I write my dictionary name as use key options and run this, then you can see it is showing only the keys, which are our Delhi, Meerut, Noida. These are the city names of India. So as you can see in the dictionary, these are the keys which are shown here. Similarly, we can also see the values. To see the values, we use the values function. The values function show all the values of the dictionary. If I run this, then you can see it is showing all the values that are present in our dictionary, means 1, 2, 3. Here you can see 1, 2 and 3. The pop function is used to delete the key along with its value. If this is our dictionary and if I use pop function and in the bracket I write my key, any key like Delhi, then this key Delhi along with its value 1 has been removed from the dictionary. So this is my dictionary after removing the Delhi key with its value. If I again use this pop function and if I choose Noida here, then it is showing that the Noida key with its value 3 has been removed from this dictionary. So this is how you can use different functions of the dictionary. We will talk about more functions which are shown here in our advanced playlist.